Morning everyone. I'm on the Hollybush pool today at Pipehill Fisheries in Litchfield, near Litchfield. Set up a maggot feeder to start with. Just while I'm waiting for my pellets to go off, just prep my pellets, will take 20 minutes to go off, so I'm just waiting for that. So I thought I'd start on the maggot feeder. On the hook I've got a little bit of cork to pop up the maggots off the bottom, and I've got a double red maggot on the hook, so it's for a bit of variety of fish in here. I'm hoping to get some tench, but apparently some good sized perch been coming out recently, a small carp as well, some chub, so we'll see how we get on. I'm just going to fish just off the island, and we'll switch to my other camera when I start fishing so we can see. Hopefully I'll be able to land it just short of the island. I've already clipped up, but we'll see if I can get the angles right. Let's see how we get on. That doesn't work for the void. Just bashed against my rod. Was that a liner? It's a little fishy. Is it a crucian? What have we got? Come on. I wasn't too sure whether it struck a bit keenly then. And the reel's come off my rod. I need to sort that out, it's too loose. It's a rod. My feeder. It's still full of the pellets there, they haven't dissolved or worked off. So that's what obviously what a lot of the line bites were, them pecking. Oh, that's the smallest fish I've caught in a wafter so far. And it just ticks over after an hour and 30 minutes of fishing. Strike my hands off. I'll take some of this pellet residue off. And now I'm going to leave that pink wafter on now. As well that I put my hook bait at the top, because those pellets hadn't popped off, it means that if I'd put the hook bait in the middle, it would have just been lost in amongst the pellets. Going to be hive. Yeah, look at that. Well, I thought that was a liner. And I lifted into it. It's definitely not a liner. Now, I wonder if I'd just left that, whether it would have developed. Missed out on the action. It's definitely bigger than the last rod. I don't know if it's a bream or I can't guess it yet. It seems quite willing to come to the net. Is it a bream? Is it a bream or a carp? It's not much of a fighter yet. We'll see. It's not come up yet. A few inches below. Oh, it's a nice common carp. Look, as soon as it's an F1. Oh, it's caught under my net. Come back. Oh, I'm fishing a bit far back, so it's a bit tricky with the net. But that's just to give me a bit of access around the left of my peg. Oh, he's a chunky one, that's nice. was in the bottom lip, he just hooked himself in the net, so I'll move out of the way. Put him back in the net. Nearly forgot. Put a bit of goo on. Don't know how much difference it makes. I bought pineapple because I was reading Tony Miles' book of that big tench. He's had good success with pineapple for tench. So that's good enough for my book. Well, that went round when I was having my coffee, so I'm pretty sure my camera was looking up to the sky, which was right in. It's interesting, when he's low, there's a tench. There you go, I was just meant to say that, and that's easy for me to say now, but those tench, they don't charge off, they just stay low, but this one charged in. £10 main line, £7 hook on the bench, so I'm quite confident, although it's a size 18 hook. Oh, my favourite of the fishies. Nice slimy green tench. I'm guessing about £1, he looks the same sort of age. Just hooked in the side there. Miles did say, tench like a bit of pineapple. Oh, lovely, slimy, soapy, wiggly tench. I just want to get a photo with him because I didn't get a photo of the last tench that I caught here on New Year's Day. I regretted that. Since tench is my prime target, I won't weigh him. I'm sure he's the same generation or same year as the one I caught on New Year's Day. My hands are getting to cover most of anyway. Sliding back. He's off. Look at those big bubbles he's leaving as he trails off. Oh, that's a nice one. Although, interestingly, the rod didn't go quite around as much as previously. Maybe I was just a bit quicker on it. Well, I thought it'd come off anything to suddenly go slack. I haven't decided what he is yet. I think it had more of a forked tail of a carp than a tench thing. And his tail just coming out the water. Oh yeah, another common. Was it a crucian? F1. Bit of both, I'm guessing. Oh. Oops, sorry fish. He's the heaviest so far. I reckon he's just under two. That's the first catch on a brown wafter. It's a today or anywhere. He's an F1, isn't he? He's got to be too big for a crucian. Beautiful fish. I'm saying he's probably just over a pound and a half. So I'll save him the hassle of the scales. And I'll just drop him back in. There you go. Lovely fish. Oh, is that a bite or a liner? It's a bite. Just prepping. Just about to see if we'll get some cork for some nuggets. Look away. Have a look at the wood. Something little, I think. It's a nice roach. He's got one hooked in the net. Is it a roach or a rod? These fins are more brown. Maybe a hybrid. Typical. I don't think I've got a good bite on camera yet. Oh, that's a nice fish, is that a chub? It is. So that's six fish. Six species. Corner hooked in the net again. This always makes it easy. It's funny, the chub, rudd and roach have all been about the same weight. About 10 ounces, I'd say, mate. Actually, that's probably only about half a pound. Space for a wafter in there. This is a better fish again. Ooh. It's not a bream, is it? It's not yet another species. It is. It's a skimmer. That was another sweetcorn on the bun this time. Another 10 amps, I'd say. It might be a rudd, I suppose. It's definitely got more of a round body, but that has a skimmer. Actually, there's no slime on the line.
I'll say it's a hybrid.
I've been fishing for 6.5 hours. I've had a fairly successful day. I've caught 7 fish altogether. So not quite as successful as I did on the willow pool on New Year's Day. So I think I'll probably go back there next time. I've caught one more fish, but they've been a smaller nature here. I've had a 1.5 pound common, an F1 about the same size, a tench for a pound, which is good because it means I've caught a tench in January and February now. I'm trying to catch a tench every month of the year this year, hopefully. I've caught a rudd, a roach, a chub, and a hybrid. I couldn't quite tell whether it was a bream or a rudd, but it didn't have the slime of a bream, so it might have been just a strangely shaped rudd. I'm counting it as a hybrid, so basically that means that 7 fish, each one a different species. So that's quite an interesting stat. But yeah, fizz, and it sparked a few times and just looked like it was going to kick off. It just didn't quite happen. Loads of line bites, but I think they may have just been smaller fish that weren't quite taking the bait. And yeah, pretty much the most successful baits were pink wafters, and then coming second was the brown wafter. I had one sweetcorn. I think that was all the baits that I caught on. But yeah, I did well. I'll definitely come back here next time when I come to a commercial, with a few trips to the canal in between.